Hello and welcome back. In this unit we will take another step with VESTA. VESTA is a great tool to display crystal structures, but it can also be used to display the shapes of crystals. You have already learned that the faces of a crystal can be defined by Miller indices. In this tutorial, I want to show you how you can draw very simple crystal shapes, with the faces of the crystals being parallel to the faces of the unit cell. In the last unit, you have entered crystallographic information to build the structure of calcanthite, and I want to use this example again. But in principle, you can use any crystal structure you can find. If you have skipped the building of the calcanthite structure, then just download the crystallographic information file, or CIF, from the Additional Resources tab. Now either open the file you have created yourself, or the one provided by us. Now go to Edit, Edit Data, Crystal Shape. In order to build the crystal shape, we need at least 6 crystal faces. We will start with those crystal faces that run parallel to the faces of the unit cell, namely those with the Miller indices 100, 010, and 001, and the corresponding lattice planes with opposite sign, -100, 0-10, and 00-1. To add a crystal face, click New. Enter the Miller indices, for example 100. In the next line, you can define the location of the crystal face. The location is defined by the distance to the origin of the unit cell. This can be entered either as the distance in angstrom or as the d-spacing of the respective lattice plane. For this simple example, I will set the distance to the origin to 1d for all crystal faces. In the third line, you can alter the color and the transparency of the crystal face. I suggest that you color each crystal face with a new color, so you can easily identify the crystal faces once the crystal shape is completed. If you want to change the transparency of the crystal face, you need to change this last value here. I want the crystal faces to be half transparent, so I set this value to 125. In this last line, please uncheck this box that says Apply Symmetry Operations. We will discuss symmetry operations in the next chapter, so we just ignore this option for now. Okay, the first crystal face is set up. Click New for another crystal face, and repeat this process and enter the Miller indices for the remaining 5 crystal faces. I have sped up the process here to save some time. Once you have entered all 6 crystal faces, click OK. Now, please change the display style. Go to the Style tab and make sure that this box here is checked. And then select Custom Color as your display style. Okay, now we have created a very basic crystal shape. Of course, you can also set other lattice planes, such as 110, or 101 as the boundaries for your crystal model. In fact, I encourage you to experiment with the crystal faces for a little while. Please create some beautiful pictures of your crystal models. You can save them as PNG or JPEG files by clicking File, Export, Raster Image.